Hold up. Pose. Yeah. Pose. Pose. Yeah. Pose.
I am.
Pose. Photo shoot. Pose.
I am. I am.
Pose. It's a photo shoot.
Pose. 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 Photo shoot. Pose. 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 Pose.
Photo shoot.
Pose. Pose. Pose.
Photo shoot. Pose.
Pose. Pose. Pose. Pose.
Bet put the free on it. If it's about money, then we on it. Water on my neck, you can ski on it. You can't under all these dollars.
Good morning, Spanish River. I'm Danielle Zeldes. Today is January 8th, 2021, and today is National English Toffee Day. Now to the pledge and the desk with Alex and TJ.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
What's up, Spanish River? It's your boy, TJ, here, and we're back with another banger. Today is January 8th, Friday, 2021. It's your first time seeing me in 2021, man. I hope 2020 was good to y'all. If it wasn't, I hope 2021 is going to be even better. But you know, things get better. New year, same me. But new year, it could be new you, all right?
And I'm Alex, and TJ's going to start us off this morning.
Seniors! Herb Jones will be on campus next week, January 14th, and then again on February 18th. And then again on March 24th from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. outside in front of the theater. Get your graduation gear taken care of. You had all this time. There is zero reason not to get your graduation gear taken care of, all right? Listen up. Spanish River will join up with Boca High from our bi-weekly KFC Google Meet meeting on Monday afternoon at 4. The Google Classroom code is SW65ARV. This meeting is open to everyone who likes thought-provoking conversations and wants to meet new people. We'd love to see everyone there. Now back to Alex.
For boys interested in playing for the boys lacrosse team, there is a mandatory conditioning next week at 3:30 on the practice field, starting Monday the 11th. Conditioning will be Mondays and Wednesdays at 3:30 for the next week until the first practice, which is Monday the 25th. Practices are every day after school starting at 3:30. If you want to play, you must attend the conditioning starting next Monday. I repeat, next Monday. Attention girls who are interested in playing girls lacrosse, varsity, and JV. Conditioning began yesterday. Meet at Johnny O's at 5 p.m. every Tuesday and Thursday until tryouts. Please make sure you've completed your athletic packets and fees before tryouts. You can turn athletic packets to Coach Matthews in room 1153C. Varsity tryouts will be held on Monday, January 25th, and JV trials will be held on Tuesday, the 26th. For those interested playing boys or girls tennis, you have to get your athletic packet and COVID release form in this week to Coach McEnroe. There will also be a Google Meet on Friday afternoon at 3:30, and tryout information will be given then. If you are trying out, please join the Google Classroom using the code below. Any questions, please contact Coach Heinrichs at robert.heinrichs.2@palmbeachschools.org. Now, on to Coach Mack with some sports, followed by Mr. Delaney with some yearbook information.
Hey, good morning, Spanish River. Hope everybody's having a great week. A lot of exciting things going on. First of all, Wednesday night's boys basketball game against Boynton Beach unfortunately had to be rescheduled due to some health issues. Also, Wednesday night, the girls JV went to Atlantic High School and won by 25 points in basketball. The girls varsity came up a little short. They lost by 8 points, but their season's going along very well, and they're hanging in there. Going forward, Friday, we have the triple header. That's what I wanted to come on. So this will be aired Friday morning. I want to remind everybody that at 4 o'clock, the girls JV basketball team will be playing Boca Raton High School. At 5:30, the boys varsity team will be playing West Boca Raton High School. And following that game, the girls varsity basketball team will be hosting Boca High. So if you came out and spent $5, you can see a whole bunch of your friends. All the tickets are online at gofan.com. Going forward next week, on Monday night, we have a soccer doubleheader. The girls' varsity team is playing Jupiter, followed by the boys' varsity team playing Boynton Beach. So if you want to go out and see your soccer buddies, Monday night's an opportunity. Also, going forward with spring sports, there's still a lot of uncertainty about when everything's actually going to physically start, but athletic packets need to be taken care of. So what I'm going to do for you people who are not on campus, Tuesday and Thursday of next week, I'll be in the parking lot in front of the theater at 7 a.m. to accept athletic packets for virtual school students. I'll also do the same thing on Tuesday and Thursday at 3 o'clock in the parking lot in front of the theater for accepting packets from virtual students. And also, again, as I said yesterday, I'm going to say it again today, I need to hear me say it all along, we have only 3.5 weeks to go, and your academic eligibility for spring sports is based on your grades achieved right now. So if you're not doing well or you need work to get done, please make sure you take care of business, get caught up, so you have the opportunity to participate that you're looking forward to. I hope everybody has a great day. I hope everybody enjoys the championship football game Monday night. And of course, as always, be a great shark, wear your badge, and wear your mask.
Good morning, Spanish River. It's Mr. Delaney from the Tiburon Yearbook. Just giving you guys a quick update. Seniors, the deadline to take your picture is January 15th, all right? I understand that there are no actual big sessions available with KD Studios. That's okay. Just go there, get your senior picture done, go into KD Studios by January the 15th, all right? So just under 10 days. If you have not taken your senior picture yet, get that complete so we can get it in the yearbook. You can always book a fun session later on down the road, okay? As you can imagine, this year, it's more difficult than ever to get them to come on campus to take the pictures, so please make sure, don't miss out. We want you in the yearbook. Get into KD Studios and get that done, all right? Underclass, we haven't forgotten about you, all right? We're trying to put something together where we can do both underclass campus pictures and underclass virtual pictures, all right? So just stay tuned. Make sure that we're going to take care with you of you on that, all right? Last thing, seniors who already took your pictures, thank you guys so much. Most of you have selected them. If you don't select them, KD Studios is just going to select them for the yearbook, all right? So we will be making many more yearbook announcements over the next several weeks, all right? So please stay tuned to WSRH for more information.
Track conditioning has started. Please meet on the track between 3:40 and 3:50 and be ready to run, jump, and throw. Bring your own water, hand sanitizer, and towel if needed. Girls flag football conditioning began yesterday, Tuesday, January 5th, on the practice field. Conditioning will be on Tuesday and Thursdays from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. and Saturdays from 9 to 10:30 a.m. You heard me. Saturdays, all right? Make sure you bring your cleats, running shoes, water, and athletic clothes to participate. New players are strongly encouraged to attend, so don't be scared. We need new players because all our seniors left. We need y'all. Please come, all right? No experience is required. Check out the team on Instagram at River Flag Football or Gmail or email at riverflagfootball@gmail.com for more information. Attention Pathfinder nominees. Listen up. You guys really need to listen because I know you guys want that scholarship, all right? Your final packets are due to Ms. Kalman by Wednesday, January 13th, 2021. I know it's weird, but 2021 at 2 p.m. Please email her with any questions you have. This next message is extremely important, so listen up. Those Pathfinders that have not turned in their nomination forms/cover sheet to Ms. Kalman, please do so immediately. That means if you gotta log off right now and do it right now, that means do it right now. And now the more teacher get to know you is followed by SGA's Wear Purple effort.
Hi, I'm Alex Samra, and today we're gonna get to know the social studies teachers here at Spanish River. Social studies encompasses a vast range of topics from history to psychology and are a large part of the school system. Since it teaches people to make informed decisions about important social issues, Let's get started.
Sharks! My name is Faith Collins, and I currently teach social studies here at Spanish River High School. I teach world history, 9th and 10th grade leadership, and world history honors.
Hello, Spanish River. How are you? My name is Miss Ostrow. I teach American history.
Hi, I'm Patrick Abbandondolo. Many of the students here that have met me know me as either Mr. A or Coach Abby. I teach U.S. history, and I teach ACE International History.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Morano, and I teach psychology, sociology, and ACE Global Perspectives.
Hi, this is Mrs. Hernandez here. The course that I teach is AP Psychology and ACE Sociology. Favorite ice cream? Well, that definitely depends on my mood, but I would say like an overall, if I had to pick coffee with maybe like Heath, I think it's like, I don't know what it's called, but coffee ice cream with like a Heath like flavored chip in it or something like that.
My favorite ice cream flavors, chocolate and coffee chip.
Favorite ice cream is cookies and cream. And my favorite way to eat ice cream is in a milkshake. So an Oreo milkshake or a cookies and cream milkshake, I will literally do anything for.
What's your favorite ice cream flavor? Moose Tracks.
My favorite ice cream flavor, I love coffee ice cream, but I'm a big iced coffee nut, so I imagine that that's where that comes from.
The biggest challenge that I faced this year is dealing with not so good bandwidth. Keep getting tossed out of my Google Meet.
Biggest challenge has been connecting with students.
Challenge of teaching this year through the pandemic has definitely been not getting to connect with students the way I normally would.
But the biggest challenge has also been trying to form meaningful relationships with our students.
Challenge really has been building and maintaining a strong relationship with the kids at home. Best piece of advice I'd give anybody, students, friends, family, whatever, is positivity and a growth mindset are the most important two things that we have in this life. If you can find a way to stay positive when things seem to be most bleak, and you always have the mind to try to grow from where you are, making, let's say, today better than yesterday was, and making tomorrow even better than today was. If you go into your life that way, if you treat every day that way, you're gonna reap dividends and benefits galore.
The best piece of advice that I would give to my students is do not forget to have some fun time.
What I would give kids would be focus on what you can control. I think when you slow down and look at it and look at what are the things that are stressing you out or even upsetting you, a lot of them are often things that are outside of your control. And I would encourage you to not allow those to be what gets under your skin and kind of robs you of your ability to be present and happy in the moment you are in. And that requires you to adjust your perspective. So I think that adjusting your perspective and to focus on things that you can control and let go of the others can be really, really helpful in a time like this.
Best piece of advice for students. I think it's really important for you to get good grades and care about school and do all the things that you need to be doing. But I also think it's really important for you to remember that there is life after high school and to take care of your mental health and to do things that are good for you. So going outside, enjoying your time, spending time with family, those things that really make you a well-rounded, happy person. So best of luck, and if you need anything, come see me or shoot me an email.
One piece of advice would be, it's not always about the destination, but the journey, right? Of course, we all want to succeed, we want to do well, but we also learn from our mistakes and our failures, and it gives us the opportunity to grow and be stronger. So I tell my students all the time in class, my goal is not to break you, but to get you to learn something. And I think that can be applied to really any aspect of life. As long as you learn something, become a better or a good citizen, an active citizen, you understand what's happening around you, and you make an effort to do good and be good, that is the most important thing. So that would be my biggest piece of advice. Not about necessarily the destination, but the journey as well. How you get there and the way that you kind of carry yourself along the way. So that's it for me. I hope you have a great year, Sharks. I've loved getting to know all of you. Hopefully you enjoyed getting to know some of us, your teachers. Be safe, wash your hands, be responsible, and make good choices. Have a good day. Bye.
Thanks for watching, and thank you to all those teachers for helping the students get to know you better.
morning, Spanish River, and happy Friday. Let's take a look at your weather. We are watching for two snowmakers as we move through the next few days into next week. This will cause rain for our area. You can see the two low-pressure systems located in the Midwest region, and theirs are going to slide off towards the Atlantic. So let me show you both of those. So the first system, it's going to bring us rain as we head to Friday. You can see it right there as it begins to slide off into the Atlantic Ocean. It's really only going to bring to the south about maybe a half inch of rain. Where we are, it's going to be even less, some snow up towards the northern parts of maybe North Carolina and Virginia, but even about only really about 1 to 3 inches. So Friday morning today, as we head out the door, you can see there are going to be a few rain showers popping through, but this is all part of that cold front line. So as soon as these are through, that's it for the day. So again, we'll be watching for maybe a few sprinkles out there, but you can see maybe a few heavier bands, but most of the activity will be offshore, just maybe one or two showers to watch out for. The second system we'll be watching will be a stronger system on Tuesday that will bring us more rain, in the sense that we will see more rain showers as the system moves through. You can see it also pushing off, going to bring a little bit of snow area. And then as we head into the latter half of next week, we'll see another strong cold front system set up and maybe possibly bring us a bunch of rain. You can see all that rain through South Florida, but that is still something in the distance, but that would be the end of next week. Taking a look at your hour-by-hour forecast today, you can see 66 degrees as we start off the day. It's going to be in the 60s until about 11 a.m. Then we warm up into the 70s. It's going to be a beautiful afternoon. Winds will be stronger, west at 17 miles an hour, maybe a sprinkle around 6 or 7 a.m., about a 25% chance. And a look at your WSRH 7-day forecast as we go into the weekend. You can see today 76, tomorrow 74, but then Saturday and Sunday, take a look at that. Both days in the 60s. As we head into next week, we're going to warm up before that front moves through with some more showers. We could see another cool day on Wednesday. Have a wonderful day, Spanish River.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Spanish River. Catch us next time with some more news.
So remember, wear purple on Monday in support of Mental Health Mondays. That's all for today, Spanish River. Catch us next time with more news.
Hold up. Pose, yeah, pose, pose, yeah, pose. I am, pose, a photo shoot, pose.
I am,
pose, it's a photo shoot.